vibes. O, buti gising pa kayo. Yep, joke lang. Alam ko namang inaabang ninyo ang nag-iisang show na nagbibigay ng good vibes sa buong mundo tuwing more night. At tayo lang yan, ang The Team Yap Show. Kaya naman ihanda na ang inyong mga sarili at tara na pumarty. Ready na ba kayo mga gaya mo, gaya ko, at gaya nating lahat na merong
isang gaya!
First, let's get this party started at heto na ang ating nightly na barang Yap Dates. Tonight's list, lalo natin pairitin ang gabi at ating pag-usapan ang sexiest Pinay comedians. Sino nga bang hot na, sexy pa, tapos funny pa? Let's all find out. First on our list, isa lang naman yan at syempre laging top of mind kapag sinabi mong funny comedian. Siyempre, si Rufa Mae Quinto, nakilala sa role niya noon bilang Buba at pagkatapos ay sinunggan pa ng ibang comedic roles gaya lang ni Marinara, ang nakakatawang sirena, kung saan pinauso rin ni Peachy ang tagline na Fish Tayo. Si Peachy ang isa sa mga halige ng Bubble Gang, the country's longest running gag show.
Eh, kung palitan ko kaya ang pangalan ko to, Rosa Mae Quinto, baka mas sumikat ako.
Next up, isa pang mainstay ng Bubble Gang at nakilala naman bilang si Neneng B, si Sam Pinto. Sino ba naman ang hindi magbibighani sa ganda ni Sam? At dahil game na game din siya sa pagbato ng mga punchline, mas lalo tuloy nagiging sexy ang kapuso comedian nito. Mukhang maraming nabuksang pinto para sa'yo ang pagpapatawa, di ba?
Lord, sana po, kiminayan lang pagbukas nyo naman ako. 7 season na kami. Kahit isang sitcom guesting lang po. Thank you, Lord.
Very talented naman ang ating next comedian at technically, hindi siya Pinay kundi foreigner. It's Natalia Moon. Napapanood ngayon si Natalia sa Small Family kung saan habol siya ng habol sa gay character ni Mikael Diaz na si Bernie. Bukod sa bibilib ka na sa kanyang galing sa pagtatagalog, eh nakakabilib din dahil pasok sa mga lagi ang delivery ng jokes ni Natalia. Galing!
Pero bakit Moon ang i-plead niya? Kapatid ba niya si Sailor?
Buntis siya ngayon pero sexy pa rin. Yan si Charisse Solomon na napapanood naman sa GMA sitcom na Pepito Manaloto. Kahit pa bungagerang misis na lagi naiinis ang role ni Charisse, sa totoong buhay, fan at kalog daw talaga siya. Character lang talaga niya ang laging pagalitan at kutusan ang asawang ginagambala naman ni John Fair.
Napapanood ko pa rin siya sa Pepito Manaloto. Baka gusto niya mag-maternity leave. Ako muna papalit!
Lastly, ang pinakabagong leading lady ng GMA Comedy, si Max Collins. Gumaganap ngayon si Max as Marie Giginto na ka-love team ni Sif Cadayona sa Juan Tamad. At kahit pa kolehyalang maarte ang role dito ni Max, dalang-dala pa rin niya ang bawat eksena at lagi ring swak na swak ang timing niya. Kaya nga hindi lang si Juan ang patay na patay sa kanya.
Kanyang asawa ni Kanyo, patay asawa ni Pato. Pam!
Don't believe me.
Pam, asawa ni Tom. Learn from my mistake. Kaya...
Did we miss anyone? May kilala ba kayong star na sexy na funny pa? Aba, i-tweet nyo o i-tag nyo sa akin ang pics nila. Tag me at official Team Yap. Isama natin yan sa susunod na listahan. Yap next, sa drama naman nalilinya ang ating guest. Pero kahit ganun, kaya rin ba niyang effectively mag-deliver ng punchline? Subukan natin when the Team Yap Show returns. Ikaw, I'm not afraid to Welcome back to the Tony Up Show. Our guest for tonight goes through indie cinema, telenovela to the theater with equal ease. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, kasama natin walang iba, kundi si Lauren Young. Lauren! Hi there! How are you?
I'm great.
Hello. Mwah. Oh, diba, Lauren, after your success in telenovelas, in movies, now theater.
Yes.
What prompted you to do this?
Well, first of all, my friend Toph de Veneja asked me, and no one says no to Toph.
I love it. Oh.
Yeah, but also because I've seen some of their previous work with the Sandbox Collective. I watched Danny Girl and...
It's a beautiful show.
Yeah, and Toph is just simply... Grabe yung mind niya. So like, I had no hesitation whatsoever to try something new, which is ito nga, theater. And I don't know, I guess I'm really just like that in my line of work. I'm not scared to do new things because it challenges me as an actor. And how else will I learn if I don't try new things?
Yeah. And were there any hesitations when you started? Did you go, ako, mahirap yata yan? Anong, meron ko mga second thoughts?
At first, I was really scared because, syempre, sanay ako sa TV and movies na kapag nagkamali ka, you can just do it all over again. But this time, it's theater. You really have to, like, come in, like, prepared talaga. So I was kind of doubting myself if I was gonna be able to do that. Because number one, we're doing monologues. So... you have to memorize like 2 pages, tas ikaw lang mag-isa sa stage. Wala kang tagasalo, wala kang cut, walang editor, anything. So, doon, I was like, maybe hindi ko kayang gawin to.
2 pages of text.
2 pages of text. And it's like, all in all, probably like 8 pages because we have like 3 to 4 monologues each. And at first, I was like, no, maybe I can't do this. But then, with the help of Toph and Sab Jose and all of my castmates, in fairness, nakayanan ko siyang i-memorize, to feel it, to put emotion into it. And I think we had a very successful first run, which is why we're coming back with No Filter 2.0.
Yes. When it comes to like your experience actually acting na on stage and you know, receiving the immediate response of an audience, were there moments that, oh my God, I forgot my lines? Or, you know, something not planned, not rehearsed happened?
Actually, during my first, because during the first weekend, it was my alternate, Sab Magalona, Bajaro. And then the second weekend, technically, they were all nagawa na nila, nakapag-show na sila. But it was technically my opening night. So first time ko on stage, and I was doing my one monologue. Parang during the second half, ako yung unang magsasalita. So I was on stage, and I just blanked out.
That happens.
I thought, the funny thing is though, I thought I wasn't saying anything, so I thought I skipped like half of my line. But then nung pala, I was unconsciously saying my lines. Hindi ko lang naririnig sa sarili ko.
Wow.
I thought I was just like ganun lang. So it was so weird.
Kasi ano yun, parang naging ano, nag-autopilot na your system. But you were saying it, but hindi mo na naisip na...
Yeah, feeling ko di ako gumagalaw. Feeling ko walang lumalabas sa bibig ko. Nung pala, ginagawa ko lang siya. Gestures pa ako on stage. It was so weird. Uh-oh.
So it was like parang na-process ka or something.
Parang out-of-body experience.
Yeah. So all you could see was the light facing you, and it's a blankness, ganon.
And all that time, I was like, so mahaba pa yung monologue na yun. All the time, I was thinking, oh my God, I messed up. I really just messed up everything. So pala, hindi ako nagkamali.
Hindi pala, o diba? So it was just your mind telling you that you messed up.
Yeah, I guess it was just the nerves.
In life, you know, when you feel that you've messed up, do you like tell yourself that you've messed up? Are you like that too?
Yeah, I mean, there are times that I'm just like, oh no, nagkamali ka na naman, ito na naman, bumalpak ka. But then, I guess... I hate myself. No, but then, I guess, of course, hindi naman may iwasan na ganun mo kausapin minsan yung sarili mo. But then, you have to find a way to, you know, turn it around and be like, no, okay, you messed up, you failed, but then, it's not the end of the world. You have to, like, redeem yourself and do it better the next time.
Yes, I think you do a lot of things differently.
Yeah.
You know, even with your personal life, you're vocal that you have a boyfriend.
Yeah.
You know, that you're proud of it. You said, bakit ako mag-ipag-relationship kung hindi man ako proud sa kasama ko? Diba?
I'm weird.
You're wonderfully weird.
Yeah. I guess, ano lang, parang, I'm just so sick of all these people who are just like so showbiz. Because, I mean like, okay, I respect you. Like, if you don't want to say anything, I mean, that's you. But then, just because a person is like that doesn't mean I also have to be that way. I just handle things differently. Like, I mean, ganun talaga eh. Like, why would I do something na ikakahiya ko? I mean, it just doesn't make sense. Di sana hindi ko na lang ginawa. And like, I don't know, like, I'm not in it kasi to be a celebrity eh. Like, I guess, like, the fame, the fortune, like, those are good things. Like, who wouldn't want that? But then, of course, sometimes I'm like, yeah, I want to be rich, I want to be famous. But then, I don't know, I tend to always just bring myself down and remember why I'm really here. It's because I love what I do, I love the people who I work with, and I like challenging myself, and I love to work. That's it.
Yeah, and you know, to think that, alam mo yan yung sinasabi mo, kasi, you know, you sort of grew up in showbiz from from your formative years to now that you have gained more maturity.
Yes.
Diba? So at least na decipher mo what you want, what you really want.
Yeah, and I guess I don't want to be one of those artists who just gets sucked into it. And then kapag nawala yung showbiz, hindi ko na alam kung anong gagawin ko. I just believe in myself so much that, you know, I think and I know that this isn't all there is in my life. Like if this went away, then I'd be confident and happy with myself na okay lang. I know that I have other options and I am capable of doing other things.
Where do you get that groundedness?
No, I guess it's because since yun nga, I grew up in showbiz. I've been in showbiz since I was 11, and so I was kind of forced to grow up quicker. Kasi syempre, I was in a work environment. There's no time to be a brat. There's no time to magreklamo.
Everything's magnified.
Yeah. So and it was really from everyone I chose to surround myself with. Like if you notice, I don't really have like super like showbiz friends, and that's a choice that I make because I don't wanna be a part of that. So I like to just really keep with myself and keep with yun nga, diba, there's a saying you should surround yourself with positive people and cut out the negative people in your life. Mm-hmm. So I just make it a practice to do that.
Ah, very good. Wow, ang dami ko natutunan in this short conversation. Marami pa tayong pag-uusapan, things that Lauren really believes in. All of that we will talk to with Lauren when we connect for the time. Welcome back to the Tinyak Show. We're talking about matters that are not so showbiz and not showbiz with Lauren Young. Diba? Lauren, okay, let's go back to your character and to your monologues sa No Filter.
Yes.
What are the concerns of your character?
Well, with No Filter, kasi, it's not like a typical play where you have just one character. In each monologue that we do, we have different characters. So my one monologue, it's parang evolution of social media. So it's just like I'm conversing with people. I can be who I want to be now, or just me. And then the other ones, I play a ditzy girl. It's called Five Millennials, One Instagram. So it just shows different points of view from the same party that we're at. So you have your stoner, the closet gay, and then you have me who's the ditzy girl, or like a lesbian, or just like the guy na parang, what are we all doing? Ganon. And then the other one, it's about a girl. She moves to New York City, and she thinks it's her dream, but then she realizes, maybe this is not what I want.
Wow.
And I actually have a new monologue. It's, it deals with internet shaming. Kasi ba, we see a lot of that now on lalo na on Facebook. May mangyari lang sa isang tao, ipopost niya na kagad. So, we talk about, like, is it really necessary to talk about
your to shame person, people.
Yeah, to air out the personal na pinagdadaanan ng isang tao. Kung tama ba yun or hindi.
Ikaw, what is your personal stand on that?
I think if you have something nice to say, go ahead and say it. But then if it's something about spreading negativity, then, you know, just converse about it in real time, in real life with people.
Yeah, and it's also, there's so much negativity going around. Bakit mag-contribute ka pa to that?
And half of the people don't even know what they're really talking about.
Yeah, gusto lang mag-isakay.
Yes.
Diba? Did you ever experience that in your own life? That you were like attacked for something and you go like, why? What did I do?
Yeah, because I'm an artista. People just hate on me for no reason.
But really? So meron ganun na parang they hate?
Yeah.
They hate you because you're an artista?
Yeah. No, it was so funny because I started, we have a new show, Marimar. And then, syempre, in Marimar, I came out during the second week. So during the first week, someone was commenting like on my Instagram na parang ang sama-sama akong tao, bakit ako ganun? But the funny thing is, hindi pa ako lumalabas ng TV, tapos galit ka na sa akin.
Oo, pero bakit yung role mo dun, kontrabida?
Yes, I'm a kontrabida again.
So you play kontrabida to your sister?
Yes.
Wow, so that's gonna be interesting.
It's fun, but then sometimes, because you know naman me, like I'm so focused when I'm at work. Mm-hmm. I have such a hard time acting with her because I just want to like talk to her and like make her gulo.
Yeah, because that's your dynamics as a sister, diba?
But then, so yesterday, like we were taping a really intense scene together na parang I'm threatening her. And I kept on flubbing my lines because like, sobrang ako natatawa sa sarili ko sa lahat ng ginagawa ko sa ate ko.
Oh, inaapi-api mo siya. At least, now's your chance. Diba? Yes. Pwede mo na siyang bastos-bastosin, di ba?
And I get paid to do
it. Oo nga, may bayad pa. That's true. See, the perks of the job.
Yeah.
Oh, galing. Okay, now, wala pa akong matulong sa'yo, so let's play some games. Okay, games is Pop Rosa's Balloons. Okay, you will be popping balloons. At may questions kang kailangang sagutin. Ayan, di ba? Ayan, mga lobo ni Lauren.
So I have to sit on it.
Yes, okay.
Gonna...
Let's start.
Here? Anywhere?
Yes, oh, anywhere.
Oh my gosh, this
One,
is so hard.
One, two.
Where did
you...
Yeah! It doesn't work!
Yeah.
No!
Ito na. Ayun! Ayun! Nasaan na yun?
Oh, it's here.
Yun.
There.
Okay, first question.
First question.
Yes.
Ang
galing ko putok ng balon.
Okay, first question is, dated a fan.
Have you ever dated a fan?
Well, my current boyfriend says he's my number one fan.
Wow!
So I guess, joke.
Very good, oh. So, galing, so with your boyfriend, he really watches you and does,
Yeah, he does. Like, he doesn't really watch teleseries, but then last night he was like, oh, you know, me and my whole family, we've been watching Marimar. And then when we were doing No Filter, biglang out of the 3 a.m. he called me, he's like, you know what? I just want to tell you, like, you're so good, and like, I really love everything that you do, and I'm
wow.
so happy for you.
But you know, in scene 2, your acting could have been...
Acting
coach pala,
play,
you know? Okay, and then let's do it. I'm gonna pop this with this, with a McCafe.
Because my butt can't.
Ayun! Okay, next question.
Oh, this is. Okay.
Yeah, next question is. Regifted something that you received as a gift. Once. Oh, okay.
But then,
yun.
No, I have an excuse. Oh. I was in grade school. I had no money.
Yes,
so, how
yes,
can
yes.
I buy a gift? So, I got this little box. So, I decided I'd give it to my sister for her birthday. But she knew it.
So, that's a regifted gift. Oh.
Yeah.
You know, one man's trash is another one's treasure.
Yeah.
So, that's totally fine.
But di rin niya ginamit. So.
Baka niya regift din niya sa ibang tao.
True.
You know, 1, 2, 3. Oh, di ba? Daliri ko lang yan, ha? Okay. This one is... Ayun, made up a story to escape an event.
Yeah.
Huh? Nasado bang boring yung event?
No, I guess sometimes kasi, like, I go to a lot of events sometimes. Mm. And you, I bet you do also, diba?
Not really, di naman.
So like sometimes parang, you know, I'm so tired from work and if I feel like I've already done my part, like, you know, show up, say hi to everyone, mingle a little, then I'll be like, I have work, I have to go.
Oh, pwede na naman talaga.
But then I still do my part as a guest.
Yes, but kasi you don't have to be there.
You don't have to be
the last guest.
Yes, exactly.
Ayun. Okay, then last, ano, 1, 2, finger lang to, ha? 1, 2, 3, ay, yun! Whew, na yung mga lobong nagpuputok, ha? Ayan. And, have you ever worn undergarments 2 days in a row?
No.
Yeah, hello. No. Hello, 3 days, no?
Ano ba? 5 days naman, oh, 2 days, ano yun?
1 week naman, sa buong run naman ng show, isa lang. Diba? Ayun, well, thank you so much for being so game, Lauren. And again, we always learn so much from you, from your honesty.
Thank you.
And that's what makes you really refreshing as a personality, not just in showbiz, but you know, outside showbiz even.
Thank you.
Keep it up. And we have something for you from our friends from Cream Factory.
Ooh, cool.
Fight the Coco and Zact.
Oh, I love this.
There.
There. Hey, thank you.
Okay, so please invite them to watch you in No Filter.
Oh, yes.
And Marimar too.
Yes, of course. Please watch me and my sister and everyone else on Marimar. Gabi-gabi po yan sa GMA after ng 24 hours. And of course, No Filter 2.0, which runs from October 3 to 25. And tickets can be found at Ticket World, when you can call 891-9999. And of course, follow us on our Instagram account at The Sandbox Co.
Okay, thank you. Thank you again. And thank you so much to Marriott Hotel Manila for being the home of the Tim Yap Show Season 7. Well, diba? Her honesty is really refreshing. And I hope more of us can be more honest to ourselves and more honest to others. Pagka honest tayo, everything will just flow and life will be better. Diba? Okay, talagang nakaka-good vibes. Dahil ko sinasabi, dapat laging good vibes para laging good night. Kasama si Lauren Yang, who are watching. Good night.